of the day on Lumen Christi Television Network. Today, the church remembers Saint Paulinus of Nola. Anyone who is praised in the letters of six or seven saints undoubtedly must be of extraordinary character. Such a person was Paulinus of Nola, correspondent and friend of Augustine, Jerome, Melania, Martin, Gregory the Great, and Ambrose, Pontius Meropius Anicius Paulinus, was born near Bordeaux. He was the son of the Roman prefect of Gaul, who had extensive property in both Gaul and Italy. Paulinus became a distinguished lawyer, holding several public offices in the Roman Empire. And with his Spanish wife, Theresia, he retired at an early age to a life of cultured leisure. After the death of his only child, the saint and his wife took a vow of chastity. They gave away their considerable wealth and retired to Spain to embrace religious life. The two of them were baptized by the saintly Bishop of Bordeaux and moved to Theresia's estate in Spain. Possibly as a result of this example, they had widespread reputations for holiness. Paulinus was rather unexpectedly ordained a priest at Christmas by the Bishop of Barcelona at the insistence of the people, and together with his wife settled at Nola, Italy, near the tomb of St. Felix, where they had founded a home for the monks and the poor. We're told they lived a very austere life, and because of his widespread reputations for holiness, he was made bishop. His last years were saddened by the invasion of the Huns. Among his few writings is the earliest extant Christian wedding song. What can we learn today from Saint Paulinus of Nola? Our reflection continues after the break. The homeless and other needy people, he lived a monastic life in another part of his home. It was by popular demand he was made Bishop of Nola, and he guided that diocese for 21 years. Devotion to Christ is a lifelong commitment. Paulinus' life had scarcely begun when he thought it was over, and as he took his ease on that estate in Spain, it shows that man proposes that God disposes. And besides that, holiness challenges us to detach from our material belongings and our giftedness and be ready to share them with others. Paulinus is remembered because he enriched others with what was at his disposal. Otherwise, we probably would not have been celebrating him today. And so true is the saying that what I gave, I have, and what I kept, I lost. I have what I gave because I have sown them in the lives of others. But what I kept to myself, be they wealth, money, materials, properties, or huge sum in my bank account, I leave this world without them, and it wouldn't make any difference. I would have nothing to show that I ever owed them. May God fill us with this wisdom and the grace to become more generous with all He has given us. Let us pray. God, you will that St. Paulinus, your bishop, should shine forth with pastoral solicitude and compassion for the poor. Help us who celebrate his merits to imitate the example of his charity. Amen. Thanks for staying with us. It's been Saints of the Day on Lumen Christi TV.